anybody going. No, Harold. Just because your arm's swollen up doesn't mean you get privileges. I know it. I know it. Yeah. If you have your Bibles, if you don't, I'll supply them. That's just bottom line. For those of you too lazy to bring them, there are all kinds of them floating around here, I think. But if you have your Bibles, Oh, is that what it is? Hey, one excuse is just as good as the other, I reckon. I guess. I'm just teasing, sis. How about Daniel chapter 7? Let's go over there and see what becomes of this. Daniel had a vision in chapter 7 of four beasts. Now, I'm not going to go into depth and detail. I could go into a lot of detail about these beasts, but you can read about these beasts yourself. And come to find out, they're not literally beasts. They're nations and kings, men, leaders, things of this nature. So I will just leave it at there, right there for the time being. there was one beast coming up and devouring the other three beasts, which of course is nations devouring the other nations, rulers and whatnot, things of this nature. I want to get down and begin with 13, where Daniel says, I saw in the night visions, and behold, one like the Son of Man came with the clouds of heaven and came to the Ancient of Days, and they brought him near before him, and there was given him dominion and glory and a kingdom that all people, nations, and languages should serve him. His dominion is an everlasting dominion which shall not pass away, and his kingdom that which shall not be destroyed. Before I go any farther, if you will read, you will see the others will be destroyed eventually. Some will last for a little while. Some will come up and almost vanish immediately. But this kingdom will never be destroyed. It will last forever. The Ancient of Days is God Almighty. It's talking about the kingdom of God right here. It will not fade away. It will not be done away with. All nations will indeed give an accord, and all peoples, all nations, all languages will indeed stand before him. 15. I, Daniel, was grieved in my spirit in the midst of my body, and the visions of my head troubled me. I came near unto one of them that stood by and asked him the truth of all this. He came to an angel that was going to explain it, so he told me and made me know the interpretations of the tidings. The great beasts which are four kings which shall arise out of the earth, but the saints of the Most High shall take the kingdom and possess the kingdom forever, even forever and ever. With that known, no matter what comes, no matter what goes, the saints of the Most High is God once again Almighty. You and I, every man, woman, boy, and girl, we are saints. If the blood of Jesus has been applied into our life, if we know the Lord as our Savior, we are saints of the Most High God. So therefore, just let that sink in. Does not matter what comes, what goes, who rules, who doesn't, we will inherit the kingdom forever, even forever and forever. No ifs, no ands, no buts. Verse 19, Daniel says, then I would know the truth of the fourth beast, which was diverse or different from all the others, exceeding dreadful, whose teeth were of iron, and his nails of brass, which devoured, break in pieces and stamped or stomped the residue or the remaining with his feet. And of the 10 horns, there were in his head, and one and of the other, which, let me do that again. And of the 10 horns that were in his head, and of the other which came up, and before whom 3 fell, even of that horn that had eyes and a mouth that spake very great things, whose look was more stout than his fellows. Now remember, these are not monsters. Well, they might be a way they act. I mean, there's some nations that are monsters, some kings that are monsters, so you could relate that to that. But remember, these are kings and nations. Rulers, I beheld, verse 21. And the same horn made war with the saints, that's you and I, and prevailed or won against them until the Ancient of Days came, which is, of course, our Savior, and judgment was given to the saints of the Most High. And the time came that the saints possessed the kingdom. Thus he said, the fourth beast shall be the fourth kingdom upon earth, which shall be diverse or different from all kingdoms, and shall devour the whole earth, and shall tread it down and break it in pieces. Now let me stop there. If you think things are going to get better, you better think again. Time is exceedingly near as far as the coming of the Ancient of Days, which is God Almighty. Church, I'm going to put it as bluntly and as plainly and as simple as I can. We know that no man, nobody can know the hour or the day or the time of the coming of God. But I can say this within my own self, my own thoughts, from what I read, from what I see. If our children are allowed, and I'm not trying to scare anybody, I'm just trying to tell us the way it is. If our children are allowed to grow up, because time is allowed to last that long, it will absolutely amaze me. That's how close the prophecy is being fulfilled. The people of the nations, they're doing everything, no matter who you voted for, no matter who I voted for, it doesn't matter. Not here for no politics. I'll let them do that stupid, dirty, lying, conniving job. But everybody is in their place where they are supposed to be to fulfill the Word of God. It's as simple as that. And if you will read the Word of God and then watch these people, you will be able to see they are fulfilling to the letter in their offices and in their positions every Word of God. They are fulfilling every little thing to the letter. Not one jot, not one tittle is being left out. 24. And the 10 horns out of his kingdom, out of his kingdom are 10 kings that shall arise, and another shall arise after them, and he shall be diverse or different from the first, and he shall subdue 3 kings. And he shall speak great words against the Most High, in other words, against God, and shall wear out the saints of the Most High, comma. Is anybody wearing out the saints, your patience? That's in any offices now, no matter where they are. They could be around the world. Just listen. And he spake, I'm going to read it again. And he spake great words against the Most High and shall wear out the saints of the Most High and think, he word there, and think to change times and laws. And they shall be given into his hand until a time and times and the dividing of times. Now, but the judgment shall sit, and they shall take away his dominion to consume and destroy it unto the end. And the kingdom and dominion and the greatness of the kingdom under the whole heaven shall be given to the people of the saints of the Most High, whose kingdom is an everlasting kingdom, and all dominions shall serve and obey him. Hitherto is the end of the matter. As for me, Daniel, my cogitations much troubled me, and my countenance changed in me, but I kept the matter in my heart. Now, church, I just want to say this. I just read a little bit of this, and instead of me going into depth and detail and trying to spend time to explain all of this that's going on, let me sum it in detail. Let me sum it up like this, the way I have started to sum it up a little bit as I went. These are indeed kings. These are indeed leaders. These are indeed nations. And brother, they are in place, and they are doing exactly what the Word of God says that they will do. They are even speaking against the Most High God, the laws of the land. We don't have to wonder if that's going to come to pass. We can already see that a lot of people have thought to change the times. Why, we're in a time I never thought I'd see in good old the USA, but brother, it's here upon us now, and they're wearing out the patience of the saints, absolutely, and it looks like they're prevailing, does it not? And brother, we even have war this going over to that country, and brother, the leader of this country going against his own country and standing for others, do we not? We have all of this stuff going on, church, but understand this. In 26, the judgment shall sit. In other words, I want to spend the time on this instead of everything else. No matter who's out there doing what, no matter what they fulfill according to the Word of God, which will indeed be every little word within the Word of God, and it will come to pass, like it or not, want it to or not, believe it or not. But understand this, it will not matter how far they man goes. It will not matter how much of flesh is destroyed. And church, know this beyond a shadow of a doubt. If America does not turn back unto God, they will be nations that will indeed arise up and come against it. And they will bring it down to its knees. That's not me making things up. But church, understand this. If America wants that, brother, you won't have anything to worry about. It's not just one, it's not just two, but there's bears and lions according to the Word of God that's rising up, and these are also nations, church, and kings and people. But understand this, America is where we live in today, so I will start at home. Brother, America has fallen, and America has fallen extremely hard. It's not above everything else. It was once upon a time, was it not? It was a great nation, was it not? It still can be today. Oh, but the people have gotten away from what saith the Word of God. And no matter who you are, no matter what nation you live in, brother, the very day we get away from the God Almighty, that's the very day a nation will come unglued. That's the very day a nation falls down on its knees and has absolutely no hope whatsoever. whatsoever. Oh, but there's nations, and it's not just America, church. There's plenty of nations. There's plenty of people out there in kingdom that think they're above this and above that. And we have it even in within our own churches today, do we not? This pastor thinks he's got it all. That pastor thinks he's the man. This pastor thinks it's his church. But praise God, brother. Just like the leaders everywhere, ain't none of it belong to them. Brother, God knows exactly what's going on. This is not my church, and you are not my people. You will never be my people. You are God's people and God's alone. And brother, that's the way it's going to stay. I'm simply put here to feed the flock of God. I'm put here to oversee and feed the flock of God. But I better be a man that in this position. I better be a man that will tell the flock of God exactly how it is. In church, I know sometimes I'll preach a message or say something that you may or may not like. But I'll tell you one thing. I'm the same way sometimes. I don't like the message that comes to me myself because it steps on my toes and it works in my own heart. Oh, but I wouldn't have it any other way because, brother, one thing I won't do is lie to you on purpose and lie to you out of spite. And there's something else that I won't do. I won't try to tell you and try to get you to buy into or believe the way I see it like so many preachers will. Brother, it's got to be this way, they say, or you can just find you some other place to go. Brother, that it don't matter to me. I just as soon as go find some other place to go, where preferably, where the word of God will be taught, where the word of God will be preached in the power of God and in the authority of the Holy Spirit. Brother, where there's no lies, and if it hurts my feelings, so be it. Because one thing I know, the truth will indeed set everybody free. But I'll tell you this right now, church. We can look around on the news, TV, listen to the radio. We can go out and see it with our own eyes, hear it with our own ear. Brother, how things are going in this old world. Many people cannot believe, praise God, the things that they've seen already in this great land, America. But I'll tell you something right now, church, as I once said, America, no matter how great it was once upon a time, no matter where the nations are across the world, the very ones that will not turn before God, that will turn their back upon God. There's nothing but chaos waiting. There's nothing but doomsday waiting. And it don't matter who we are. But brother, man has got it in his own mind, does he not? And he's purposed it in his own heart, has he not? Brother, don't you never think that one leader of one nation won't be over here telling you something to your face. And just like the Bible said, at this table he's like that, but at the other table he's a whole different ball game altogether. All of that is playing out, brother, just like God said it would. If you think a man will not stand and give his and go against their own land, and brother, take up with somebody else, thinking he's going to be all right and thinking everything that he's done is going to be fine, let them all perish because I'm going to have it made. Oh, there's people like that around the world, church. Don't you never think there ain't. And it will indeed attempt to wear out the patience of the saints. Oh, but understand this. It don't matter, praise God, of who does what. It don't matter who stands up against God. It don't matter how many there is. Because I don't care who it is, they will indeed fall. Brother, the blood of the one that the Son of Man falls upon, it will not only grind him, it will not only crush him, it will grind him as powder, will it not? Brother, there's only one kingdom that's going to stand, and that's the kingdom of God Almighty. And if you're in that kingdom, praise God, you ain't got nothing to worry about. If death comes your way, behold, brother, to leave, be absent from this body is to be present with the Lord. So death better don't have no sting. It shouldn't have any worries with you. You shouldn't fear death. You shouldn't have too much trouble with it at all. Why? Because death is one thing. It's an enemy, is it not? But God has made his people at peace, has he not, with their enemy? That's why a person of the Lord can simply roll over so easy like and go to sleep in God, because there's no fear there. And I'm so thankful for it. But church, no matter where you go, no matter what you get involved with, don't you allow your heart to look around before I go any farther. Is the people being discouraged today that claim to be a child of God? Absolutely, and I can understand why. It's harder than you may think, church, to get up and stand and preach the word of God in a world like today, when the people want to mock you and not listen to you at all. But a man of God has that calling upon him. And if he's going to be the man that God called him to be, he'll still stand there, will he not? And church, if there's only two people that come out on Sunday morning, praise God, the man of God is still willing to stand and preach the word of God, is he not? You think it doesn't affect the man of God the same way it affects the children of God? Absolutely it does. We get discouraged like everybody else. Why? Because we're in the flesh. We get down in sorrow and filled with trouble many times, just like everybody else. Why? Again, because we're in the flesh. Oh, but there's one thing the preacher man tends not to do. That's allow himself to lay out of the house of God. Why? Because church, if I was to start doing what also many people are doing, how are you going to get fed? What's going to become of the church that God wants to be here? Brother, let me tell you something. It's my job to do my best to my capability to be an example to the flock. And no matter if the flock wants to come or not, this old boy is going to do his best to hold on to the word of God. I'm going to do my best to be true to what saith the word of God. A church, I know within my heart, I know within everything down inside of me that the day of God is swiftly approaching, and people don't even realize how close it is. But I'll tell you this one thing. Consider this, church. It's already been at least 2,015 years. If the Lord allows about 4 more months to go, we'll see 2,016 years go by. That's a whole lot of since the time the Lord came upon this whole earth and said, repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand. How much time, praise God, do we think God's going to allow this chaos to go on and on? All of this adulterous and wicked generation of the sin that's going on left and right, and people just accepting everything, and brother, and everything is becoming normal. If time is allowed, I'll guarantee you one thing. You see two men and two women together holding hands and carrying on in the street, and if it's allowed so long, goes by, it'll become a normal thing to you and I. Oh, but I'll tell you something, church. That's not the only thing that's not normal, but there's so many other things. But we have been seeing it and seeing it and seeing it, have we not, for years and years? And it has a tendency to come, just be something of the normal, of the norm, they say. But brother, it's not normal in God's eyes, and nor will it ever be a normal in God's eyes. A brother, he destroyed one, he will indeed destroy again. And there'll be no nation under God, no nation under heaven that will be able to stand the kingdom of God when the Lord comes back. And brother, I don't care what suit you wear, you ain't getting out of standing before the King of Kings. How many think they're king? Brother, they're going to look upon the King of Kings. How many think think they're Lord and ruler over so many people, they too will stand in faith of the Lord of Lords. And brother, you and I will be right there. But I'm so thankful to know, brother, we're going to be on the right side, and the right side down here, and we're going to be on the right side of the Lord when he comes. The sheep will be gathered on the right, the goats or the world will be on his left. The sheep enter in, thou good and faithful servant. You've been faithful over a few things. I'll make you ruler over many. The goats on the left, depart from me, you workers of iniquity. I never knew you. And church, understand this. I know that you tried and tried and tried again. Some of you here within the sound of my voice. I know that it's extremely hard to put up with the world and everything that's going on in it. I know that already, church, because don't you dare, I'm in it with you. I'm right there with you every step of the way. Oh, but I thank God to know, brother, we've got one that goes before us. His name is Jesus Christ of Nazareth. He's the God Almighty. He's the great I Am. And brother, he comes behind us as well. He is our rear guard as well, is he not? And brother, his angels encamp all round about us. The time will indeed come when some men and some women, they will be tried and pushed to the limit, and some of them's already met that fate. Brother, we're gonna be made to prove what we stand for and what we don't. But I'll tell you something, church. If you don't stand for something, I'll guarantee you this. You will fall for any old thing that comes along. But brother, God was deserted. Was he not, Jesus in the flesh? Everybody deserted him. Everybody forsaken him. When push came to shove, there was nobody there to back him up. Even though there was there people that said, I'll die for you. Even though the rest will run and forsake you. I will not leave you, Lord. I will even die for you, Lord. But we knew better all along, did we not? Jesus came to die for him. Jesus came to die for me. Jesus came to die for you. And I'll remind you of this, church. I don't know where you are in your life when it comes to worshiping and serving God. But I will get ready right now. Yeah, I'm going to step on some toes, I'll guarantee it. Because, brother, I'll tell you one thing. If there has not been a change in you, yeah, there's something going on that art not be. When the Lord comes into your heart, he comes into my heart. Brother, there's a change within ourselves. And I don't go around with my filthy mouth the way I used to once upon a time. God took it away and put it away from me. But how many people are still got that same kind of thought going on? And brother, their children are hearing it as well. And everybody gets to hear it and see it. And I don't know who's there and who ain't. It's just something the Lord wanted out. So I had to spit it out. But it all comes down with this right here to church. There's people playing. And there's people playing and pretending. It ain't just out in the world. It's right. It's in the church as far as the church as a whole. We got people behind the pulpit playing pastor. People behind the pulpit playing preacher. But you let what they call their church, their flock, their people go somewhere else. You watch how fighting mad they get. You watch how ruffled their feathers get. Same with nations, the kings, the leaders. Everybody wants the power, it seems. And most of them are willing to do whatever it takes to get the power, it seems. But I will tell you this, and that's all I will say. Just as the Lord said to King Herod, it still goes today. You could have no power at all, except it be given unto you from above. God has all power in heaven and in earth. What plays out in this world, don't allow it to get into your heart, sink down into your being, and stay in your mind to where it destroys and roots out the joy that God once gave unto you. How many people are doing that today? They're allowing everything that is done, every stupid decision made by man, they are buying into it, looking at it, and they're dwelling on it, and they can't seem to get over that. Oh, that makes me so mad. That makes me so sick. He ain't got what he needs to stand up and be this and to be that. I see it. I hear it all the time, church. But brother, that ain't going to get nobody anywhere except away from God. It's going to get us so far away from God if we allow that kind of mindset. The devil has got it set up, praise God. And brother, let me tell you something. If we buy into it, the devil will take us down hook, line, and sinker. But brother, God's already given you and I the grace to get past all of that. He's already given us victory in Jesus, praise God. But without Jesus Christ in our life, the flesh will surely perish. The flesh is extremely weak, church. It can't handle what man can dish out. And you and I know that already. Oh, but God passed the test, did he not? Jesus came down and went through it all. And brother, he overcame every bit of it. In this old world, you will not have peace. You will have heartache, trouble, trial, sorrow. But oh, be of good cheer, saith the Lord, for I have overcame the world. And brother, if he overcame the world, and he did, you and I are already more than victorious through and by Jesus Christ, which strengthens you and I. Let man do what he's going to do. Let the leaders do what they're going to do. Let the nations do what they're going to do. I can't take care of all of that. I can't do anything about it except pray like Daniel did. Lord, it's me again. You see your people, you see your nation, they've all turned against you. I can see what the leaders of the nations are doing. I can see how they're holding hands with the devil, holding hands with the enemy, while they're trying to get the people of the land to buy into this and to buy into that. I can see it all, Lord, because you don't withhold it. You don't withhold the truth from me. Let your people see this. Let us know that and not focus on it. We know what's going to come to pass. Everybody's in their places as it should be to bring the word of God to pass. Nothing more, nothing less. Oh, man, I ain't gonna go out and vote no more. I ain't going to do this no more. It just don't do anything. God sets up, God takes and removes. God blesses, God tears down, destroys. God gives life, God sends death. Sends death. God has the power over it all. I want to sum it up with this. The judgment shall sit, and they shall take away his dominion to consume and to destroy it unto the end. And the kingdom and dominion and the greatness of the kingdom under the whole heaven shall be given to the people of the saints of the Most High, whose kingdom is an everlasting kingdom, and all dominions shall serve and obey him. Hitherto is the end of the matter. As for me, Daniel, everything changed within him, but he kept all of this in his heart. And church, it comes down to this. I know, like I said earlier, I know that the